ovens where we dry stuff. And so you can see these tops.
During the engagement, the Infectious Disease Institute, IDI, Global Health Security Program, with funding from the UK Department of Health and Social Care, and Mort MacDonald, under the Fleming Fund Grants Program, handed over microbiology equipment and a fully refurbished microbiology laboratory to Mbarara University. Professor Joseph Ngonzi, the Dean, Faculty of Medicine at Mbarara University, attributed the practice to the high degree of drug resistance.
Okumira eddagala buli kaseera n'omubiri gwo gweyongera okumanyira eddagala eryo n'otuuka ekiseera nga terikyasobola kukola. Kati teeberezaamu omuntu ng'oli mulwadde naye nga tewali eddagala lisobola kukolera. Awo oba otandise okusemberera entaana. So aba omuntu wa bulijjo omukubiriza nti bw'oba ng'oli mulwadde olinawo ebintu ebikuluma.
Professor Ngonzi says the laboratory will support antimicrobial resistance surveillance and provision of diagnostic microbiology services for patients' care.
We have everything now to take off, but we need an automated blood culture machine to help us to increase our speed of culturing blood.
Speaking to journalists, Dr. Mohammed Lemoud, the head of Department Global Health Security Infectious Diseases Institute, said so far 9 laboratories are being supported by the program in different regions in the country.
We also have 4 laboratories in animal health that we're supporting in the project. In the next 2 weeks, we're actually commissioning 4 laboratories of the project that have been renovated. This is one of them here in Mbarara.
Meanwhile, the National Drug Authority has embarked on operations to seize illegal drugs sold out in open markets and other places. This was revealed at a veterinary practitioner's training in Kamwenje district.
We realize that there's a lot of irrational drug use at farm level, and even if National Drug Authority authorizes a good quality drug, but if it is not handled well, then its quality deteriorates and the farmers are not going to benefit from such drugs. So we have decided to tackle the topic of appropriate drug use, whereby we go to each sub-county, call farmers, call the district administration and the sub-county administration, the chief, the chairman 3s, chairman 5, RDC, GISOs, to educate them around about rational drug use.
The principal human resource officer, Musika Jaffes, decried understaffing, saying farmers have fallen victim to fake drugs due to failure to access authentic services.
We can't invest in their own. And I must say yes, because we have seen them. This has not been because maybe it is from their own making only one.
We should sensitize our farmers to stop using agrochemicals and stick to the rational use of the registered acaricide on market.
The National Drug Authority has vowed to withdraw licenses from veterinary doctors caught selling counterfeit drugs. Story by Anthony Atwine and Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news.